Welcome to St. Charles Borromeo Catholic Church for our celebration of the Eucharist on this sixth Sunday of Easter.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace, the peace, and the love of our risen Savior be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Here in Clay County, we were among the first in the metropolitan area to be able to offer assembled masses, church services on Sunday. Last week, about 50 to 60 people per mass, and a few others who came by afterwards to receive the Blessed Sacrament. We will emerge from this COVID-19 virus and our isolation period very slowly. And it's a good opportunity once again to thank those who are on the front lines, for public servants, for healthcare workers, for scientists, for grocers, and for those in this community of St. Charles Borromeo who reach out to one another, looking in on a neighbor, calling a friend. That is the spirit of compassion and of goodness, a Holy Spirit. In our scripture today, we are reintroduced to the Spirit of God that is among us and within us. Let us take a moment to reflect upon our journey of these days and ask Christ, the merciful Lord, to forgive us of our failings.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call on us sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. We raise our voices to praise God in His glory.
Glory.
Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, these days which we keep in honor of the risen Savior, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. We ask you this through Jesus, our Redeemer. Amen. As we open our ears, minds, and hearts to the Word of God, we reflect upon that collect that we will always hold to that which we do as we seek to imitate the actions of the apostles long ago as they welcomed the Spirit of truth. Let us pray that that same Spirit will descend upon us.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now, when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear so that when you are maligned, those who defame you, your good conduct in Christ, may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ suffered once for sins, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see him, but you will see me because I live and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by the Father. And I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord. You know, it's easier, and maybe we take it for granted, to live our faith when times are good, when times are basically normal. It's those times that aren't normal, that are harder, that are difficult. Then we find out, though, how much strength we draw from our faith and how important that is to us. Well, this is the way it was at the time of the reading of the gospel today. For the disciples, they weren't sure what was going on. They weren't sure where they were going. They didn't know that what was going to happen exactly, but they knew it wasn't going to be good. They were distressed. They had fear. And it was a very difficult time for them, not knowing the future. And so our Lord knew that they were distressed. And he knew for us, just a couple of months ago, certainly, as we entered the coronavirus pandemic, that we entered a period that we're looking forward into the future, which is really unknown. We're kind of learning every day. We know that it's dangerous, that it affects every aspect of our lives. And yet our Lord taught the disciples then, and us now, what truly is important, what we should be focusing on, what is in our lives that really can help us. And we know that as he taught the disciples, and we listen, the first of which is love. 5 times in these short 7 verses of the gospel today, he uses that word. And through the evangelist John, he always stresses that love is not just to be reduced to an emotion or a symbol. It is the only thing that is true that we can count on. And the second is obedience. If we keep his commands as he's taught, we love him. Because the true definition of love is obedience. He loves unconditionally the Father. He wants us to love him as well. And he returns that love in that trinity of love to us. There's nothing less that is acceptable or real. And if we're receptive to the Holy Spirit, if we're open, the advocate that he leaves us with is the aid that we have. Because of our inabilities and our human frailties and fallible nature, we need help. He's trying to give us the idea and the notion that the consistency in our life needs to be the stability of our faith, of our love, and how we live it. It's a lot easier said than done. We're not perfect. We need help. And that's why we've got the advocate. In the Greek, parakletos is the word or the phrase for the Holy Spirit. And it meant the one who counsels us, who leads us, particularly in times where we might be confused or experiencing difficulties. It's what helps us get through the loss of our friends or close family. Certainly there is sorrow, but through the help of the Holy Spirit, we come to remember and realize that we're all so happy for that loved one who is now entering their new birth and new life in Christ. It helps console us. It helps us feel stronger. In the Latin, the word was fortis, which means the one who is brave and the one that helps us obtain braveness, gives us that strength. So I'll simply end with this, that as we continue, we are continuing as equal members of the one body. Whether we're gathered together or whether we are part, we are still the communal faith of his church, as we always have been and always will be. And we will get through this by the strength of our faith, by the strength of the leadership and the counsel of the advocate left for us.
As we continue to reflect then upon the Trinity of love and that great grace that is given to us through the Holy Spirit, I'll ask us to reflect upon what it is that we believe and once again to make our profession of faith. Do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
And do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith, the faith of our church, and we are so proud in this Easter time to profess it with great conviction, that Trinity of love. We now turn to our Heavenly Father as we advance closer to the end of the Easter season, as we approach the feasts of the Ascension and Pentecost, and then the feast of the Holy Trinity and the body and blood of Christ. We are mindful of that advocate, our representative, our lawyer, the one who defends us before the ultimate judge, that constant companion and consoler, let us turn to our God and ask that our prayers will be heard and answered.
For all the baptized, that we proclaim Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our towns and cities, that they pay attention to the Christian message this Easter season and receive it with joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cannot accept the Spirit of truth, that their hearts be converted, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all affected by the current outbreak, that our compassionate Father would touch all affected with healing and peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the sick and homebound of our faith community, that the love of Christ will shine forth from those who care for and visit them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Anthony and Rose Canaleo, for whom this Mass is offered. That perpetual love of the Holy Trinity be with them forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord, our loving God, as we reflect upon the faith that we profess, the faith of our baptism, as Jesus himself was baptized in the name of God, the first Christians baptized in the name of our Savior and Redeemer, and those in the first reading that we hear today baptized also through the Holy Spirit, we are mindful of that trinity of love, and we pray that the grace of our God will continue to guide us in all ways. We ask this in all of our prayers through Jesus, our Savior.
Amen.
Lord our God, may our prayers rise up to you together with these sacrificial offerings so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. We ask you this through Jesus, our Savior.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly, it is right and just. It is our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but especially at this time. In this Easter time, above all other times, to laud you yet more gloriously, for Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of the light will rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom will be thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every nation, every people exalt your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all that you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and workings of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And then you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit that you will graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought before you for consecration, so that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and once giving thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper had ended, Jesus took the chalice from the table. And once again, giving thanks, he said the blessing. And then he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and glorious ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and this living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body and one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the mother of our Lord and our God, with blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the apostles and the glorious martyrs, with Charles Borromeo and with all of the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church here on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, with the order of bishops and all the clergy and the entire people whom you have gained for your own. And listen graciously, Lord, to the prayers of your family, those whom you summon before you, and those who remain in confinement and isolation. In your compassion, most merciful Father, gather to yourself all of your children who are scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters and all who were pleasing to you at the time of their passing from this life, give kind admittance into your kingdom, we pray. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Jesus, through whom you bestow upon the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Continue to contemplate the Trinity of love. We are mindful of how Jesus taught us to pray by referring to God as our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but look at the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your sacred will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us reflect upon the Prince of Peace and that peace that dwells in our own hearts. And let us consider how we are called to share that peace in our world today. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Gratitude for all that the good Lord has given to us and the gift of the Holy Trinity, let us stand to give thanks and praise. Almighty and ever-living God, you restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, and you increase in us the fruits of the Paschal Sacrament. We ask that you will now pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food to nourish us and to give us that strength that we need to go forth on our pilgrim journey to guide us along the road to heaven. We ask this in all of our prayers through Jesus, our Savior.
Amen.
Amen. In addition to those small numbers that are gathering for a church here on the weekends, we also have the weekday mass where people feel more comfortable to come wearing their masks and sitting in assigned seats following our social distancing guidelines. I did not in any way imply that these small numbers are a bad thing. They're probably a good thing. And I reiterate again with Bishop Johnston and so many others of the importance for us to stay safe and to be in the comfort zone that we need to be in.
as we emerge slowly, cautiously, and lovingly, thinking of others as we emerge from this time of confinement. So we pray that the Lord God will continue to be with all of us. Let's see each other in our prayers and keep one another in our good thoughts. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us this day and always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.